we believe that life is inherently valuable, if we think that other species are worth preserving, and we recognize that most of the universe is barren, then it follows that we have a duty not only to defend life, but to spread it. If life is the most valuable thing in the universe, then perhaps, in a sense, the cosmos itself is depending on us to do this. Like birds carrying seeds to uninhabited islands. Maybe that's our role in the galactic ecology.
Thank you. can't imagine spending years in such a desolate place. For what? Science? Enlightenment? I'd much rather be back home in New Jerusalem.
I think it's beautiful, in its own way. But I don't understand how our ancestors could survive here. They were so fragile. Imagine getting stuck out here in the cold. I wonder if there are wolves.
It's kind of a miracle biological humans lasted as long as they did.
Congratulations, 1K. That was a hard one.
Saying about how in the end the sea will claim everything. I have no doubt that this is true. In the long history of the human species, entire regions have disappeared under the waves. Places like Beringia and Doggerland still echo in our cultural memories. But we shouldn't forget that life began in the sea. We are the children of the sea. And it's not through floods and ruin that the sea will claim everything, but through us.
Now, I have to talk science fiction for a bit because I love science fiction, but it drives me nuts. There's this cliche that shows up over and over, and every time someone uses it, everyone pretends it's really profound. It goes something like this. A scientist invents something good, but, oh no, it's actually really bad. You could have something that makes your life better, but no. You can't. How dare you even want it? That's hubris. That's playing God. And it's never anything that reflects the real world, right? It's never, oh no, you invented a vaccine for cervical cancer. Oh no, you invented a new class of antibiotics. Oh no, you cured malaria. How dare you? Those diseased mosquitoes are way more important than human lives. How did science fiction become so reactionary? You know, if we all thought this way, you guys wouldn't even exist. At least Alex agrees with me. She has good taste.
Looks like it has something to do with energy generation. Am I reading this right?
I wonder what it was like when the ancients were still here. Their world seemed so lively.
Not always in a good way. Interesting times are great to read about, but rarely great to experience.
That's true. But they left behind so much art and philosophy and religion, and so many strange stories. Is New Jerusalem like that?
It was, in the beginning.